Okie doke. So this is the first cut of my long-awaited, multi-year wait for a Lake Bloomer Gardens sign. The bottom is going to be made out of this beautiful maple, right? Maple? That's
maple. Is this
maple?
I don't remember.
I think it is.
No, that's cherry.
So this is the bottom piece. This is the top piece where the red, we're gonna utilize the red from this for the background of the logo.
Look at that, everybody. Is that exciting? Okay, don't let me stop you. See the back of this, Jack, so I can see the name of that. It's called
Binga.
Binga.
You don't need to rush.
Oh my God, hurry up, glue.
Yeah.
It's quite thick. Do I try to cover all the surfaces?
Yeah, without going crazy.
No, you can spread it.
You should be able to spread it. Don't push so hard.
I see it. Yeah, I was doing that.
Yeah, you can move some of this up there.
Does it need to be even all over?
No.
How close?
That's pretty good.
This is kind of.
Oh, as close to the edge as you can without.
Yeah, because this
going
is
crazy.
The main back, so this is the full size of the sign. So you want it to the edge as much as possible.
But
about to squeeze it. So.
Yeah, we'll squeeze it and then it will overflow, but. Make sure
but this is where the design is going to appear, right? Out of this? Or no, I'm confused.
Mm. Yeah.
But it'll cut through the...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
It will cut through the glue.
Well, that looks pretty smooth.
Yep.
Okay. Am I good?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want me to rinse this off?
You just set it.
Yeah, I just set it in the tray.
Okay.
So that means we need to put a couple of biscuit slots in it, but because we need to do it in the bottom and we have to cut and flush. Kind of hold here and steady, even push straight in as you're pulling the trigger.
And let me take measure. Quarter.
What did you just do, Chad?
We put domino holes in there. This is how we're going to clamp the piece down. We purchased a special clamp system that somebody designed and made so we can clamp the material down while the CNC is running on top.
Oh, got
it. Without having to clamp from the top. So it's clamped from the side.
Cool.
It's holding it down on the side.
Technically, that's called biscuits.
Oh,
the festival one is dominoes, but it's the same.
It's a biscuit?
Yeah, it's called a biscuit.
Because we're planing the whole top surface using the CNC machine, we can't use clamps like this to hold the material down.
Right, because what you're going to be doing is smoothing this out, right?
We're smoothing all this out.
This happened as a result
of I believe is when they were running it through the planer. It was jammed up somehow and the teeth of the planer probably cut into this.
Okay.
So we're smoothing that out before we cut the artwork into it.
This bit is going to smooth the whole surface?
Yeah, it's gonna cut.
Oh wow. Oh wow. Okay.
And the other end is too. Oh, it's very sharp.
Yeah.
Very.
It looks very sharp.
I think we did center origin, right?
Job is 1 pass, 1/16. You can control everything, so you can watch it.
Just look here.
Watch it when it comes around and then comes back. You'll see how much the step over is.
Okay.
See?
Thank you. Is it going to stop?
Yeah, it's just going to do a edge.
Wow.
Kind of random because it's only the tool pass where it should fit.
Thank you.
step by step, the coordinates instructions that it's running. Right? So that's basically like you driving in your car.
Like a GPS.
This right here is the job setup. So we're defining that piece of wood with height thickness, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we're saying our XY datum origin point is the very center. So all of the measurements are off that center. And so everything has been defined in here of where everything is.
Wow.
To match that piece. And then
we have to make the canvas of the artwork the same size or as close as the piece, physical piece that's
right
out there.
And then the Z position, which is this direction, how deep to go down.
Yeah.
Right? We set it to be the very top of the material.
Mm-hmm.
And as we switch bits, I'm going putting a new bit in that's different lengths. Right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then I'm going back to the piece of wood,
mm-hmm,
and zeroing that Z axis to say here's the piece of wood.
Mm-hmm.
So then it knows its depth up, mm-hmm, and down as it moves.
Oh, so that's the way it's developed. It developed that way. Oh, that's amazing.
So it's just, you know, mocking up the toolpath.
Sure.
Of each step that it laid out.
I can't wait till it gets to the tomato. Oh, there we go.
It's only doing that stroke for the tomato. It's just like...
This is the highlight?
Yeah.
Pretty near impossible.
You'll be able to use a small drill bit. Should have a tiny little bite to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm able to loosen it up.
Thank you.
inside section is stayed. Good glue up, Kay. Good glue up.
Oh, thank you. That was my contribution.
It's important.
Yeah, it those holds bees, everything in place.
The inside of that bee, I'm impressed that it stayed.
I am too.
If you enjoyed this video, please watch these. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And I'll see you in the next video.